Hi everyone, today's action point is the last one of the Key to Change Raise Responsible Boys Cactus Foundation India Initiative 12 action points. Can you believe we've finished with 11 and this is the 12th one that I'm getting to you? And there's so much I can talk on this. I have my own 3-day workshop that I can take on this. I have mini workshops and everything in line with this basic action point. And this is one of the most fascinating, you can say, area of my interest. And I'm going to be putting that before you. This, is the cycle of male violence against women, especially against women, the LGBTQ community, children or the soft targets that needs to end. And the gender-based violence, it actually tears millions of them on a yearly basis. It tears people apart, and there are broken homes, fractured childhoods, and it's a huge crisis, I would say. Paul Kivel is one of these pioneering person who came up with a concrete theory that actually talks about what are the stereotypical definition of men, and he comes up with the most common beliefs that generally society has about how men should be. So Paul Kivel comes up with this concept called act like a man, and that Porter later on kind of made it more flexible, and then he termed it as the man box. So imagine that, like, we have an imaginary box, and the society has put in a lot of qualities on how men should actually be. And the list is, I would say, endless, and it is very, very, and that basic expectation of the society, which we can call the basic gender stereotype about men, and that is what the man box is all about. So many times it happens that even if we are very educated, we are progressive, because of our gender biases. Like, let's say if my partner, who's a male, is not being assertive, is trying to show that he's scared or he's afraid, the first instinct in me as a woman is I don't like it, because he's not aggressive enough. Because even in my mind, I've been conditioned to think that yes, men should be aggressive, and they have to be strong. They cannot show that they are weak. So these beliefs in the man box, or these beliefs of the society, are shallow. They are negative, and they are these basic ideals of self-sufficiency. Like one of the thing is self-sufficiency, which means that I'm adequate in myself. I don't need any help. So that is the kind of thinking that the society has, that men should be thinking about themselves as self-sufficient, who don't need anyone. And the next is acting tough, which means the society wants men to act tough. They want if you're a man, you're tough, and if you're not tough, then you're not a man. So this pressure is why exactly we are doing this 12 action point, and we're talking about raising responsible boys, because this pressure of toughening it up, acting up like really, really strong, is a huge burden on the boys who are growing up. They don't want to. If you ask men per se, and if you ask boys per se about their individual beliefs, I think most of them will say that no, their beliefs don't align with what the society is expecting from them, but they have to fit into that role. They have to kind of align with that role because of the pressure, because of the situations, and because of the cultural lens that they are operating into. The next is physical attractiveness. Men have to pay attention to physical attractiveness, their own attractiveness. So they have to have a body, you have to have abs, you have to have a well-sculpted body, as well as, you demand that from, and you kind of have this belief that, women like tough men with abs and with who can flex their muscles. So this is again a concept or a parameter in the man box. The man box or the society also has defined and, very rigid gender roles, like these professions are for boys and these professions are for girls and these profession are for these list of things is what girls do and these list of things is what boys do. So blue is for boys and pink is for girls. So there are different, you know, rigid what you call as roles, gender roles that are there in the man box. So the man box is basically the set of beliefs that the society has on how men should be, and these are these parameters are not invented by they're not invented by Paul Keevil, but he got this through the responses by engaging with a lot of youngsters, a lot of men, and these are the responses, and then he kind of zeroed down them to these parameters where self-sufficiency, acting tough, physical attractiveness, rigid gender roles, heterosexuality and homophobia. Now this is again another important thing, because if you're a man, you have to be heterosexual. You cannot be gay and man at the same time. So you can imagine you cannot. And that's why they say if you are not tough, then they tease you like you are a sissy, you are a pussy, you are a gay, you are not straight, or you are whatever. You know, every culture has their own cuss words and slangs to call out men who don't act tough, are not men enough. That is the basic ideology in most cultures, 99%. And it's true even today in times of Instagram and in times of Facebook or social media, it still holds true. So there's homophobia, and the one more parameter in the man box is the aggression. So you have to be aggressive. If you're a man, you have to be aggressive. If I have to give you examples, because of the man box, boys tend to grow up into men, and men generally think that women are objects and we own them. So you can imagine the effect of man box. Like, women are objects and we kind of own them. They are our property. So you kind of deal with women like objects and as like a property. Boys and men should not openly feel or express their emotions. So you have to have that guard, that armor of manhood, where you don't express your emotions in society, publicly, or wherever. So you just have to be guarded all the time. So next one is boys and men cannot show fear, or they cannot show weakness. You know, this is also what is a part of, or an example of how men specifically get stuck with the man box, and that's how what the society is demanding from them. And I'm sure you have heard, when your 2-year-old cries because he's hurt, quick comes the response, stop crying like a girl. So like a girl, like a boy, these phrases are again the definition or a very integral part of the way the man box operates. The man box is nothing but the belief system that the society has on how men should be. The man box expects men and boys to be decisive, you know, so the decision making has to be in their hands. The control needs to be in your hands. You cannot be giving control to the other gender. So that's why men who are stuck in man box will resort to violence, will resort to aggression, will resort to passive aggression, will manipulate, will stonewall, will do anything that they have to gain control in a relationship. Are you getting me? So I hope you understand the repercussions of getting stuck in the man box. And also that men cannot ask for help, or they shouldn't ask for help. I know this video is going to get a little longer, but this needs to be told. As a psychologist, I have so many women who come to me, you know, because there's this clinical depression, and when you get to know the cause, they say that they have not been able to conceive, and conception is a challenge. And then when I go through their medical reports and everything, I come across the fact that the woman has no problem at all. Everything is clear. Everything is perfect. In fact, the men or the man has a problem, and this woman is suffering just because the man feels that it is below his dignity to go out and seek therapy or treatment for his low sperm count or for whatever dysfunctional issue that they have, because this man whom I'm talking about is a man who's stuck in the man box, a man who believes that then they, you know, you kind of start torturing your partner, and that is what happens, and it is horrible. It is horrible. I can't express the ordeal of such women and that manlyhood that they want to kind of impose, and they kind of play blame games, and they kind of malign the woman. They kind of and she's forced to take the blame that she is not strong enough, or she is not healthy enough to conceive. And then this is something that happens in so many marriages, especially I would say in my clinical practice I have seen hundreds such cases where it's difficult for men to accept that they are dysfunctional. So that's where hypersexuality and their ideas of sexuality are such, which actually say that, okay, we are not going to seek help. If we have a problem, we won't seek help, not just sexually, but even physically, financially, socially, or emotionally, and on any level. The man box is kind of trying to hammer on young boys. The man box is nothing but the society's expectations that we are talking about. So there's a constant hammering. You can't ask for help. You are self-sufficient. You just can't go and ask for help. So these boys are taught not to offer or accept help. So when I'm saying not to offer help, it definitely means that if your partner needs help for anything, you don't offer it, because you're going to control that relationship. You have the remote. You always have the remote in your hand, and you're the boss. So this attitude of dominance, this attitude of toxicity, this attitude of aggression, do you think it's going to do any good to the young boys who are watching, like, so many living examples of man box around them? That's why Cactus Foundation has come up, and this is the action point. Break that man box. Talk to your boys and allow them to come out of this man box. And what happens is, this man box is not just a set of expectations. You are supposed to believe in those expectations, which most boys and men do. 99% of them, they have this belief. Yes, that is true. Men cannot cry, men cannot do this, and men cannot act weak and all of it. And they're not just supposed to believe in it. They are supposed to take part. They're supposed to participate in it. They are supposed to be involved in it. So let's say you have these washroom stories, and you have these boys' locker room talks and stuff. If as a boy, young boy, maybe that's not aligning with his values, and if he's not participating, the whole gang who is like so wanting to be on the top of the man box or of that pyramid, they kind of pounce on him, call him names, bully him in case if he stands very firm on his ground, and they kind of single him out. Or what happens is, this poor chap kind of just gives in and surrenders and says things that he doesn't believe in, does things that he doesn't believe. Because if you have to be a man enough, you have to prove that you are a man by doing all these things, by being an aggressor, by violating, by showing control, by not asking for help, and all by showing the toughness. So all this is so crap, but this is a reality. This is surely a reality. And someone, please, we need to take our boys seriously and sit and tell them that this concept of man box and this sort of peer pressure that is being exerted outside, in his friends, outside on the social media, wherever, should not be taken seriously. What needs to be taken seriously is your own inner worth. What needs to be taken seriously is that there is something known as gender equality. There is something known as respect. There is something known as dignity. And the fact that if you're a boy, you are a human being. And if you're a human being, you will have emotions. And that is a sign that you're living and kicking. Someone needs to talk to the boys, but nobody is talking to the boys. Such an important thing. And that's why we are saying that let's teach our boys to break this man box. Let's tell them, let's create our own healthy manhood, you know, definition of healthy manhood. Let's kind of, challenge this man box, because this is the root cause of gender inequality. This is the root cause of gender violence. This is the root cause of gender discrimination. This is the root cause of not just gender-based violence, but I would say for most violence in different areas of the world politics and world society, yes, the man box is definitely one of the strongest reasons or strongest you can say contenders, or is the root of all evils. So I think, and what happens when boys, young boys, are so pressured? Don't you think it's going to stress them out? Don't you think it affects them? It does affect them. It affects them terribly. And I know young boys from the age of 7 till the age of almost 10, 11, they get raped, they get sodomized, and they don't share it with anyone because they are taught. They are taught with these unspoken rules around in our society that you are not supposed to cry. You are not supposed to tell, anything. You, it's a man's talk. So that is how people groom these young boys. It's a man's talk. So it's just between boys. So you can't be going out and talking it out to the girls or to anybody, to anyone. So you can imagine, I know so many young boys who suffer in silence. They suffer sexual abuse, they suffer physical abuse, they suffer bullying, they suffer harassment. It's very difficult for these boys to come up and speak up if they are being targeted, if they are being harassed in any which way, because of these unspoken rules and this imaginary man box, which is nothing but a box full of toxicity. So these beliefs need to change, and you have to know that young men are progressive. They are progressive, but they need to be more firm. They need to set rules. They need to set examples. They need to break these stereotypes, and all the men have to come out strongly and get over these rigid gender expectations that the society has set. So that's very, very important. As a parent, as an educator, it is very, very important that you highlight the harm and the toxicity of these expectations from the society. And you have to be a role model yourself. As as parent and an educator, you have to be very vocal about this. You have to be, because in India, we put this rangoli, and rangoli is, I don't know how to say this, but okay, we decorate the front, we decorate our homes with a powder like thing, which is beautifully, there are beautiful patterns drawn out of it. And generally, traditionally speaking, it is supposed to be a girl's thing, but why not boys? Boys can also do it. But I've seen when my friends, when I've been playing with, as a child, when I was growing up, I've seen my friends, if they took interest in drawing the rangoli, they were reprimanded for it. They were shamed for it. They were told nasty things like, are you a girl? Do you want to wear bangles? So this sort of attitude needs to change, and you need to allow boys and allow young boys to do what they want to, and not restrict them based on these gender stereotypes. So as educators, as adults, I want you to disrupt these gender stereotypes. I want you to talk about gender biases. I want you to address and highlight the gap between the toxic masculinity and healthy manhood, and how they need to be away from that man box and towards healthy manhood. So masculinity is not bad, but toxic masculinity is something that I would definitely not propagate. And it's important that we engage our men and boys into critical conversations about intimacy, sex, consent, about feelings, about emotions, about relationships, about personal growth, about everything. So that those critical conversations need to happen. As teachers, you have to work on the multicultural aspect where your boys are growing up, and you also have to challenge the sources of man box. The moment you see someone who's trying to trouble a young boy with that man box theory and trying to say, oh, you're not a boy enough, you need to challenge it. And as adults, we need to stand with these young boys so that they feel supported and they feel confident and they realize, yes, this is not true. I can have my own views, and I can be the man that I want to be, rather than, you know, get into that box what the society wants me to be. And simple things that I want young boys to know is that it is okay to express and embrace your full range of emotions. Teach this to your young boys. Let them feel scared. Let them come and tell you that they are scared. Let them tell you what they're afraid. Let them tell you that they're vulnerable. It's important that boys show their vulnerability, because when you're vulnerable, you know, courage comes only with vulnerability. So if you want to have courageous, responsible boys, you have to allow them to be vulnerable, and you have to teach them that vulnerability is not bad. You have to teach them expressing your feelings is not bad. You have to teach them that they have to validate the feelings of other men. Like if they see their friend who's crying, as a boy, don't say, oh, don't cry like a girl. In fact, if your boy is raised well, he can probably go and assist the other boy and say, oh, I understand how bad you must be feeling right now. It's okay to cry. So we want to have a generation where boys can have these conversations and validate each other's feelings. I want boys, young boys, to ask for help. And parents also should encourage that they actually ask for help. They should be able to value lives of others as well as their own lives. They should treat others with respect, with dignity. They should kind of take interest in women and in girls. Boys should take interest in women, in girls, in the LGBTQ members, but not from the sexual perspective. Beyond sexuality, they should be interested in knowing these genders as individuals, as human beings. And I cannot quote this enough. I mean, I'm so strong. Like, beyond sexuality, they have to take interest in people. They have to use a language that is full of compassion. They have to take interest in others, you know, for the kind of inner worth and the people they are. They themselves, as boys, should model healthy, positive behavior so that, the other boys follow them. So this special episode or this special action point is for all those dads out there, for all those mothers out there. It's time that you talk to your boys. It's time that you kind of hold them, you hug them, and you tell them that, you know, I will guide you on your journey of healthy manhood. Don't believe what the world is trying to tell you, or don't try to get into those rigid, nasty, demeaning, violating definitions of what a man should be like. You are a real man if you can feel others' pain. You are a real man if someone can trust you. You are a real man if you are committed in a relationship. You are a real man if you can be loyal in a relationship. You are a real man when you weep seeing someone else in pain. You are a real man when you can show your vulnerability and express and be brave and be courageous. So there's so much that can be done, and this is a promise from our side. Cactus Foundation will not just stop this till, you know, at the end of March. We have taken this thing seriously, because there are so many sexual abuse survivors who are boys, and we want to reach out to them. We want to tell them that you are not alone, and that it's okay, and there is no such thing as man enough, but you just can be a healthy version of yourself and set an example, and you are a man enough when anyone around you feels safe with you. That is the definition of real man, according to me. You are a man enough when anyone around you feels safe. You are a man enough when you are not just a bystander, and you kind of take a stand and talk, you know, and take some action when you see there's something wrong happening. So I hope you like these action point series, and I hope you come back to Cactus Foundation, and I hope you send us your messages, your feedback, and your comments, or your questions to us, and keep us in your prayers, and loads and loads of blessings and loads of wishes for all the young boys out there. We are hoping that you will create your own healthy manhood definitions and make this world a much, much, much safer place. And I hope you will be a part of the solution and not the one who is the instigator of problems. Thank you.